So I really want to go over this question with you guys. Here, we have x being a real number, and we would like to know how to simplify square root of x to the third power. And in this video, we are not going to touch on any complex number. Okay, we have these four options, and you know the deal. Go ahead and pause the video and put down what you think in the comment first before you continue to watch the video. Done? Okay, here we go. Before I do this one, well, I would like to talk about the typical case that you have to know first. Because as you can see, the tricky part for this is the absolute value. Do we really have to use it? So, let's take a look right here. Suppose we have square root of x squared. It looks like we can just cancel the square root and then the square, right? And we just get x. Almost, because this expression allows us x to be a negative number. Right here, I can put in that, say, negative 3, and then square that, and then square root that. This is a perfectly okay expression. Well, no complex number needed, because you will have to do this inside out. Negative 3 squared gives us positive 9. Take the square root for that, we end up with a regular 3. Done. But earlier, if you just cancel the square root and then the square, it looks like we'll just end up with negative 3. Right? That's what this formula says, right? You just cancel the square root and then the square, you just get whatever dx back. This is no good, because this is not okay, because the output of a square root, whenever we use this symbol, it means the principal square root, the output should be non-negative. So what do we do? Well, don't worry, because we can just attach an absolute value around the x to force the result to be non-negative. So if you do the same thing, once you cancel the square root and then the square with the absolute value, and you see absolute value of negative 3 gives us positive 3. Of course, it checks. So this is totally legit. When x is a real number. Now, I think this is what most of you guys were think about when we are trying to simplify square root of x to the third power. So I just put on like a little question mark. Okay, square root of x to the third power. X to the third power is the same as x squared times x. And it looks like we can just break them apart as square root of x squared times square root of x. And then it looks like this is just that. Cancel the square root and then the square, attach an absolute value, and then the x, and then square root of x. So the answer should be b, right? Well, I will tell you, if you put down b, it's not that wrong. If you use the absolute value right here, it's technically okay. Yeah? Okay. Here is the reason why. When we have square root of x to the third power, well, we have to make sure that the inside is non-negative. So we will have to say x to the third power is greater than or equal to 0. But this implies x is greater than or equal to 0 because we have an odd power. In order for this to be greater than or equal to 0, x has to be greater than or equal to 0. So we already have this condition because of how the expression is written in the first place. So in fact, all the things are non-negative. Unlike earlier, when we put this down right here, you see how when we have x squared, x was okay to be negative because you had to square that, so you end up with positive. So in order to avoid using complex number or whatnot, we had to attach the absolute value just like what we mentioned earlier. But we do not have to worry about that in this situation because of the domain for this right here in the first place. So in fact, you can simplify it. Just you get x square root of x, and then you are done. Because right here, yes, you can see, this is also telling us x is greater than or equal to 0. So you definitely do not want to have absolute value on the inside. So definitely no, definitely no. Because the moment you have the absolute value around the x on the inside for the square root, that means you can have negative numbers for the x. That is not what we have originally. But this is good. And x has to be non-negative. So if you have the absolute value, it's just extra, and sometimes it's no good. Yeah, so I will tell you the answer is A, but if you box B, I'm not going to mark it wrong either. It's just not that correct.